2019. For those of you who have had an opportunity to read them, you happy to approve them as a correct record?
Approved.
Okay, I'll just sign that then. Thank you. Any matters arising? Straightforward meeting, won't it? Okay, so we've asked Peter to do agenda item 4, which is a pooling update to let us know what's happening in the morning.
Paragraph 3.1,
1997, in fact, both of us did. Since then, we have received a letter from the Minister. You and I met with our counterparts from the other two funds in the Northern Pool, and we're proposing to have a workshop with a number of advisors on the 28th of March, where we'll discuss in detail the implications of pooling and the practicalities of setting up a regulated company. As I said, under Section 2.2, we've also now formally joined the infrastructure pool, which is between five funds at the moment.
services consultancy drives due to an increased budget provision for cooling. I did notice it's going up the budget for next year to £1 million from expected £716,000 this year. Just wondering if, do we know if the other local authorities we're cooling with, are they experiencing similar expected increases in these consultant fees?
Yes, we're all, as far as possible, engaging with one firm and sharing the costs between us to keep the costs to a minimum. So, yes, all legal and other costs being incurred are being shared between the three firms.
Thank you.
Thanks, sir. I'd just like to see reassurances on 2.7 on the services, people on those support services.
Thank you, Chair. There is the standards of service that we receive from Wirral is expected to stay the same. There's no intention at this stage to change that. It's kept the same purely because we do not know at this stage what the recharges will be, but that will be fairly important in this moment.
Thank you.
Yeah, on 2.6, which has already been raised about the services and consultants fees going up to just under £1 million, and the other funds having similarly raised their projections on that. I mean, you know, the government's drive and their own drive here on this pooling agenda is that there will be efficiencies further down the line, and that there will be economies of scale by coming together, by funds coming together. So is the long-term expectation that those figures and costs will be driven down and not continue to rise in future years?
Certainly our July submissions are coming indicated that the Northern Pool as a whole is expected to reduce costs or make savings of about £30 million per annum by 2033, which is quite a long way away. In the interim, we're certainly looking implementation of the directive, not on the directive itself. But in my response, I have mentioned our concerns about the effect of the directive on us. But under the relevant risks, if the current proposals are implemented and local authorities are reclassified as retail investors, there are likely to be serious consequences for the effective implementation of pension fund strategies going forward. And under 3.2 in particular, such a reclassification is likely to prevent local authorities accessing the full range of asset classes and vehicles that are currently used to implement investment strategies. The consultation closed on the 4th of January, but submissions have been made by industry organisations such as the Local Government Pension Scheme Advisory Board, the Local Pensions Partnership, the Local Authority Pension Fund Forum, and individual LGPS funds. We also mentioned our concerns to the Minister when we met him on the 19th of December. Our response to the consultation is attached as an appendix to this report. Members are asked to note the potential implications and the ongoing consultation process. Thank you, Chair.
Okay, if I can make a comment on this, there are implications to all the firms, and at an executive meeting of LAP last week, it was discussed in some detail, and LAP, the Local Authority Pension Fund Forum, are putting a forum working together, and a presentation will be made to the Government Minister, Marcus Jones, on the 31st, in the House of Commons, to give him the opportunity to make changes to or alterations to this particular piece of legislation so that it won't disadvantage the fund. So a lot is in hand on this, and a lot of pressure is coming to bear so that these changes won't affect us in a negative way. But if there are any questions? No? Okay. Thank you. Right, agenda item 7 then, sorry.
Thank you, Chair. The purpose of this report is to inform members of the procurement of a pension administration and pension payroll system on the delegated authority by the Director of Pensions. The last procurement for this IT system took place on 1st of January 2010, where a 5-year contract was awarded to AWD. The fund also exercised the option within this contract to extend that for a further 2 years, meaning that the contract expired on the 31st of December 2016. Funds are encouraged where appropriate to make use of framework agreements in order to obtain value for money. In paragraph 2.6, you see that Northumberland County Council established a framework agreement when it took participated in a major procurement exercise. It was competitively undertaken under EU and other procurement legislation. Haywards were awarded that tender from a successful evaluation by Northumberland County Council. Under paragraph 4.1, an options appraisal was carried out by fund officers and Wirral Corporate Procurement to ensure that value for money and other considerations could be taken in regards to utilising the Northumberland Framework Agreement. This was confirmed, and the commercial arrangements with Haywards were negotiated for the period of 1st of January 2017 to the 31st of December 2021. Under paragraph 8.1, I can confirm the commercial arrangements with Haywards will continue as pertaining to the previously awarded contract. And under paragraph 8.2, you'll see that in financial terms, the sum for this contract period is not expected to exceed £1.6 million. Members are asked to note the procurement of the Haywood Altair system for a period of 5 years by a call-off contract from the Northumberland County Council Framework Agreement in accordance with EU and other procurement legislation. I'm happy to answer any questions.
Okay, so we've been asked to basically approve the response to the existing contract on the procurement exercise. That one, yeah.
No, Chair, it's not an extension, it is actually it just happens to be with the current incumbent supplier.
Sorry, any questions? Are we happy with the report? Okay, thank you.
opportunities is of secondary importance to MDF compared with the security and liquidity of the asset. Council parties are reviewed on a regular basis using a range of information detailed in their new rules. Section 3 informs committee that the Treasury Management Policy is concerned mainly with the mitigation of risks. The recommendation is within section 13 of the report and is that this committee approve the Treasury Management Policy and Treasury Management Practices for MPF for 2017-18. Thank you, Chair. Happy to answer any questions.
Okay, seems a quite straightforward report with an appendix. If we have to approve that recommendation.
Back to the last.